just had a conversation with a mother yesterday. Her son is a ninth grader, so he's just starting high school. And she was asking, what can she do as a parent to get her son ready for scholarships, get ready for college? And the analogy I use, I coached for 17 years, varsity basketball, track, football. And I was telling her that the analogy was, you don't win on game day. Mm-hmm. You win in preparation for game day.
Sometimes just the change in thinking won't do it by itself, right? We gotta put the thought into action. What is a lifestyle change, right? My husband and I, it was Taco Bell and Walmart. I was Walmart, he was Taco Bell, right? That's where a lot of our money was going. So the adjustment, one of the adjustments in lifestyle for us was stop eating out so much. Krishan McCook, fine. I don't want to, right? But no, that was one of the adjustments that we had to make in lifestyle. And it was also, okay, you understand that I go to Walmart for one thing and I come back with 20, right? That's fine, you gotta have a budget, right? So if you're going to Walmart, I had to start creating a list, using my checkoff, and then getting what I need, looking at the funds and say, okay, I guess I'm done. Now, it's hard, right? Because we work every day, we bring in money, we wanna buy it, right? But that may not necessarily be the lifestyle we need at this point.
So green people are creative people. They're creative types. They're very enthusiastic people. Let's go presidential. Green people are Barack Obama. Not because he's great and handsome and stuff like that, but literally very enthusiastic, charismatic. They want to do new things. Everything about them is creating something new. They don't want to do anything old the same. So if you meet these people in life, they typically come across like when they walk in the room, like, wow, a little bit of a breath of fresh air. They're sky the limit thinkers. They sound like they're going to NASA. They might even tell you, like, we're going to go to the moon. Problem is, they don't know anyone at the moon. They don't know anyone at NASA. They have no connection. So these people, a lot of times, are wonderful workers. They're in everything. They do taxes and this and that and this. They have like this multiplicity of things. But if you look at them closely, they can't really finish. So I'm a green, yay for me. The tension lies right here, right? So I'm gonna talk through the tensions first. I'm gonna teach you green, I'm gonna teach you red. You gotta understand that this is like a problem, okay? And then I'll teach you this color inside. So reds. Reds are awesome people. We start with that, okay? But they're not gonna come across so awesome. They don't smile much. Very intimidating. My mom was a red, and I thought like she just was a mean mom, but no, she was literally a red. Reds exist in control. A lot of times in business, in the real world, they're your accountants, they're your lawyers. They are rights and wrongs. They have yes and no down pat. They're very conservative in their appearance. You're not going to catch a lot of different colored hair, a bunch of different looks, that new trending stuff. They don't get into that because they're always trying to control what risks. They are existing for all this crazy new stuff, all this, you want to go to the moon, hovercrafts, what? The cars open up off the side. They're electric now, you plug them up, they're always on. So who's going to explode? Who's going to die? How are we going to fuel this up? What's it going to do to our economy? It sounds awful. Okay, green President Barack Obama, red presidential candidate, guess.
Red.
Recent.
Trump.
No. Very rigid, very starch. They don't look happy. Really recent, the last presidential election we just went through.
Hillary. Yeah.
You remember the whole, no one, they ate her up on just how she looked. Remember? She didn't look warm. She didn't look trusting. She didn't look believable. She didn't look happy. She didn't look like she liked women. She didn't look like a woman. Remember? They got her. And I thought, wow, it's just she doesn't know how to. It's not in her to, that's not a thing. Even with her daughter, when they showed that clip of her to kind of normalize her towards her daughter, there still wasn't that huggy, tippy thing. And if you catch a red mom, and you check them, unless their love language is touched, they're not super affectionate. I mean, I've been at this a while. I travel and speak through a Mommy and Me Dream Bigger tour. I speak to tons of moms. My daughter and I were on a 5-city tour, and I've sat there and I've met these red moms, and I've hugged them. And you know what? They need a hug. So a lot of times, yellows will bend the process. So if you're yellow, you have to control what you believe. You have to monitor what you believe. If you look at terrorist threats, the
and things like that right now. Can you imagine if they're yellow? Can you imagine that an entity is yellow like that, that wants to kill people and hurt people? But they have a strong belief. It's a negative one, it's a probably an improper one, but it's a strong belief, and then they have the ability to what? Collaborate and do it together. I didn't say that, you did. Any group of people that can combine together for purpose and belief with no profit, that's the key. Because there's a lot of people that get together and it's for profit. That's what we're doing there. But for no profit, no gain, they are literally blowing themselves up, blowing up people in the name of some really serious belief. So the beautiful part about yellows is they are your rider guys. They're the ones that are going to rally. They're going to show up. You see that problem? Nah, he's our president. Oh, I gave it away, my bad. Who's the blue president? I'm sorry, I did it again. Trump's blue. And so some people might say, oh, Ebony, Trump doesn't like women. Trump doesn't like black people. Trump doesn't like Muslims. Trump doesn't like gay. Trump doesn't like anything that doesn't make money and finish and done and drop mic. And no more hashtags, and you don't have to have a big social media fight about it. Because if you look at it, his wife is internationally born, yes, an immigrant. He liked her enough to marry her, right? There's inconsistencies, and everybody's looking at it as hypocrisy. There's one consistent thing about this man. And if you watch it and pay attention to his tweets and focus and don't get overdone by the rhetoric, watch the money. That's the game that's really being played. All the other stuff is entertainment. He's mastered that. There's something else happening here. So whenever you see us get close to figuring this out, all this extra random stuff comes. So just say the most crazy, some outlandish thing to do to divert the process so we can focus on this. Now, those of you that agree and understand that, you can disagree with me, you can love Trump. I'm just trying to give you value and facts. Listen to him carefully. Blue's talk blue. His favorite word is winning.